The 2014 ITM Cup is proudly brought to you by the TUI Brewery.
Game 5 of the opening round of the ITM Cup 2014 comes to you from Westpac Stadium in Wellington, where the home team will host the mighty Mulu from Waikato, and co-commentary, former Bay of Plenty prop Ben Castle.
Thanks, Kim. Well, yeah, game 1 for the ITM for these two very proud provinces. Wellington beaten 2013 finalists, a big motivating factor for them to start well. There are 5 new caps in there for Wellington and 8 for Waikato, so it's a game full of opportunity tonight.
Exciting 9-10 combination. Brad Webber, the captain, new captain, and Damien McKenzie. Really looking forward to watching those two kids run around tonight in the ITM Cup of Waikato. 4-6 in 2013, finished the round robin in fifth position on 21 points. A moderate finish by their usual high standards for Waikato, and they will be looking to get off to a very good start tonight. And for the home team, Wellington, Tolu Fahamokio comes in as a late replacement for Reg Goods, who withdrew an hour before kickoff. Brad Shields, at just 23 years old, out of Taita College and the famous Petone Club, will captain Wellington for the very first time. And the veteran Fatonu Fili comes in after Ricky Flutie tore a hamstring in the pre-season. And it's a pretty cool night. Carl Tanana, former New Zealand Sevens captain, sideline.
Yeah, good evening, Ken and Ben, and everyone watching at home. After the Storms would thrash the city Thursday, Friday with hail and lightning, the capital has turned on a brilliant evening tonight with little wind to speak of at ground level. And this ground is in prime condition for night footy here, Ken. Going to be a good one.
It will be, as Ben Castle alluded to, a number of players on a debut. Our pathway through to the elite level of the game is very quick these days, Ben.
Well, there's an opportunity. There's club form for these guys. They've played well in club rugby through the year. They get rewarded with an opportunity tonight to push for higher honours, as we see Waikato now. Some great young talent led out by their captain, Brad Webber.
Ben Tamefuna, very much a senior player now in spite of his young age. Been in wonderful form for the Chiefs in recent seasons. Damien McKenzie, captain of the Christ College First 15 in 2013. Damien played for the New Zealand 20s in 2014. An exciting kid with a tremendous potential. Damien McKenzie played a little bit of fullback and a little bit of 10 for New Zealand in the 20s, but he is most certainly a specialist. First 5'8", who's just been signed by the Chiefs for 3 seasons. Not big. He's used to playing with not a lot of football, but he's a creative player with good footwork, a good passing game, and he's a big threat with the football, Damien McKenzie. For the home team, Wellington, 9 wins and 1 loss in the regular season. They finished on 42 points in first position before losing to Canterbury in the final. Second best attack and the second best defence. They are a serious threat in the ITM Cup, Wellington. And they open their 2014 campaign with a home game tonight. We talk about young kids playing tonight. We're looking forward to a young Lenny Upside. There he is in the middle of your screen. Year 13, last year at Wellington College. Lenny Upside. He's a young kid out of the North's Club here in Wellington. And at the other end of the scale, Fatonu Fili, brought in as a late replacement after Ricky Flutie tore his hamstring in the last preseason game. 32 years old now, Fatonu Fili, out of St. Pat's Town, Marison Pats. He has had a great club season, Fatonu Fili.
They've had some injuries, Wellington. Had a close preseason. There is Lenny Apisai again. There's Ben Tamefuna. There are some two big front rowers going at each other tonight. This is the trial for this ITM Cup match in the stadium. And the man making the call down the middle is referee Shane Dillon.
get over these kids. Land Rover First 15 Rugby in 2013, ITM Cup in 2014.
Perfect, thank you. Skipper. Good.
Ambrose Curtis, he got some wheels, the New Zealand seven star out on the right wing. So Wellington with first use of the football. Brent Shields into midfield with Viafita's a strong ball carrier, the blindside flanker. Now Philly thinks about a bit of field position.
Play on.
In the quarter, Kinsey. Payne into midfield. That's a good carry, but then Wellington in possession of the ball. Faha Mokio with a strong run. Fatonu Philly with a kick into some vacant space, and the chase coming from Ambrose Curtis. And now Waikato under some pressure. The chasers for Wellington have arrived 4 metres out, and from a standing start, Waikato.
Hands on.
Weber. Kenzie. Woodward into midfield. Woodward immediately into contact. That's Tolmar Mair in jersey 11. Kahu, Philly, flat ball. Faha Mokio. Now Eric Sione.
Now this man here, eight's a tackler, entitled to play for it, holding on.
Well, some running rugby to start, some good play from Wellington, but good work equally at the breakdown there, Waikato. Just isolated Eric Sione, the ball popped out. We'll see in the ruck there. Just slightly isolated, Waikato very good over the ball, but a chance to relieve some pressure, and well, 1 minute 40 on the clock, first stoppage of play, it looks good.
Yeah, pretty messy in there for Wellington there, Ben, but I like the influence, and Ken's already spoken about it, of Fatonu Fili just placing their ball in the corner, knows this paddock so well, just getting his team in good position.
Well, in the tens tonight, we are most certainly seeing the master and the apprentice. Mitchell for Ross, McKenzie, Byrne, Weber again, forwards operating wide of the ruck. This is very good go forward from Waikato now for three phases. Again, forwards at first receiver. Honeck with a good carry. McKenzie on the move. Ball back on the inside for Weber. Good play from Weber, and a little bit of space. The ball back over the top. Damien McKenzie. First game. And his first try for Waikato.
Oh, what a start, Waikato. A nice penalty earlier on to relieve some pressure from that man there. Good clearing kick, and then they just look so organised on attack. We'll see it here, Brad Weber. There's McKenzie on the back, but look at Weber's strength there. Great fend. And he just keeps going, and then McKenzie following up, and too much speed to go over. Great first try, Waikato.
Yeah, well, a couple of issues here for Wellington, going backwards in defence firstly, but also missed tackles. One there, two there, another one coming up. But what about the confidence of McKenzie? Not only did he take the line on, the vision to give the inside pass, and the nows to back up as well. Good start, young man.
Damien McKenzie, well, I've had the pleasure of watching this kid the last 3 years through our coverage of Land Rover First 15 Rugby, so I've seen him do that at schoolboy level. Normally he's a creator, and this time he's the finisher. And the goal kicker as well. So as close as it gets for the perfect start for a rookie. Jason Woodward returns after 2 years at the Melbourne Rebels. Weber Dern. Still a behind pass from Weber to find McKenzie. And now Wellington on the counter attack. Shields in between two defenders. Kahu at first receiver goes flat. Back to right side, Philly. Well, Fifita gets the ball and a defender.
Ball's out.
Declan
O'Donnell. Ball not out, offside.
Oh, just a bit eager there, Waikato, but it's good defence from Waikato. They are coming up, they are flat. Yeah, eager. They look organised tonight. KT down there.
Yeah, they do, and they're all talking, communicating, working as one. I think that pass over from Fa'atonu Fili should have gone to the outside. They had numbers down this blind side when they came back. You can see it here. It was actually a missed pass, but Fifita there put his hands up and grabbed it. If it had gone to the left winger, could have been a little bit of a sniff there.
Boys, so your throw, nice good space. Same for them, please. Out. Out. Red. Red. Out, black, in, please. Fine.
Up his side.
Inside five, you're up.
Or Fifita at the front of the line out. Shields. Wellington keeping it.
Hold red.
Plus, they've got good position.
Hands are on play.
Fifita. Second carry in three phases. Far more Kiore, he's been prominent, the front rower. Philly, Trevi with a little delayed ball for Told Marmere coming from the left wing. Philly, Lloyd, Fifita. Fifita with a ball back on the inside for Brad Shields. Patient build up. Fifita with an offload, Trebi. Strong run from Trebi. This is good continuity from Wellington. Brad Shields plays halfback. Kahu at first receiver. Got some forwards in midfield, and now they're a chance. Ambrose Curtis straightens the attack. Wellington through Wall. Shields. Very direct one. This is very patient from Wellington and very strong defence. Far more Kior. Very prominent contribution from the new front row after nearly 8 minutes in the game.
Ball's here.
Wellington. How well are they going? They've had the ball for 1,000 phases. Ball's 10 metres out.
Use it.
14. There you go. Now Kahu. Philly, cut out ball in midfield, good footwork from Woodward.
Use it!
The ball was meant for Philly, Jared Kahu. Long for via Fifita. Offload, but no one there to take it. Brad Shields tidies up, close to the touchline. Heads in field. 16 phases now from Wellington. Another pick and go. This is great defence from Waikato.
No.
And good
Simon.
Concentration from Wellington.
Out red!
Kahu sending forwards towards the post. Philly showing no interest so far, wanting the football.
Stay here, red.
Jared Kahu again goes short. Now they go wide. Philly, Trebi. With a little show and a delayed ball. This is good running from Wellington. 5 metres out. Pele Siuma is close. Woodward. Went lateral. Now he straightens up. 3 metres. Far more Kior. Can he get it? No. He's turned on his back. And he's stripped of the ball. Great defence from Waikato.
Scrum 5 black.
Wow, how many phases were we there? We had 20. 20 plus. Great defence, Waikato. Let's see a bit on replay here. Great little short
Red,
ball.
30 seconds, let's go.
Pele Siuma. And again, 30 seconds. Here we are. The big man.
Sorry, boys. I've got to take time for a boot. I need him.
He's made a big impact in the first 10 minutes of this game.
Yeah, but look who was underneath. BC. Was at number 10 again for Waikato. Damian McKenzie having a huge influence on this game already as a young man. Doesn't look out of place. You would have put all money on the loose head for Wellington going over there. Statistically, a huge mismatch in size, but
30 seconds speed
all
up.
Comes down to heart.
Time on.
Well, Waikato could take some confidence out of their defence. A lot of phases thrown at them. They went wide, they went close, and Waikato stood up. But now the pressure's on. Two big front rows going at each other. This will be a good, interesting tussle. Ben Tamiafuna, we know a lot about him at Super Rugby.
I like that little interplay too between the 12 and 13 for Wellington. Also, Sean Treby, the strength, and Taliasuma with a nice little change of angle. Look for those two.
Jared Kahu. Messi. Kahu forced to take it forward himself.
Hands on.
Wall. Faha Mokio. Eric Sione. James Wall. Muscle their way through the middle now, a little bit wider. Woodward with a little stop and start. Got to the outside of the Waikato defence.
Offside.
You need to tap it, champ.
Nice run, though, for all that.
Look good, though.
Shot. Shot a goal.
Well, some reward. Five. Should be offside. A fairly straightforward 3 points now, Wellington. But some great defence, really. Yeah, just number five, just getting slightly ahead. Number five, Waikato. David Morgan.
How well is this bloke going? Tolu Fahamoa-Kio on the bench. I mean, pitched into the starting lineup late. Reg Goods, I suspect Ben would have played big minutes. And this boy has made a very big impression in this opening 12 minutes.
That's the beauty of ITM Cup. We unearth some of the talent around. Tolu would have been waiting for an opportunity to get on the park. May have expected 5-10 minutes tonight. Now he's making every post a winner. Now Wellington up 3 points.
Out of the Tawa Rugby Club, who won the Jubilee Cup in 2013. Motu Matu'u. Jeffrey Tuamanga Allen got injured playing for Maris and Pats against Wainuiomata in the semi-final of club rugby here in Wellington a few weeks ago. As the ball lost forward, so Waikato through Uhila with a nice offload, Weber. And a little hole and a nice ball from Honeck back on the inside.
It's all seat there.
Douglas. McKenzie. Byrne. Weber. Quick off the mark, Weber. In behind the Wellington defence quickly. McKenzie. Cut out ball. They're a little 2-on-1 down the left side. Waikato. O'Donnell.
Try 11.
Oh, what a response from Waikato.
Joe Weber, the try scorer.
It's just Brad Weber there, number 9, taking the initiative, sniping round the ruck. Creating some in behind, some go forward ball for Waikato. For Joe Weber, here he is here, here's Brad Weber, the skipper, leading by example. He'll snipe all day around the ruck. And that just came down to numbers. Damien McKenzie summing up the situation. Ben Tamiafuna involved. And here he is, Joe Weber, 7's exponent. And a good finish. That's just off a sloppy mistake at kickoff for Wellington. Pressure back on themselves. Some good hands from the big man there. It's a good try.
Oh, that's all fine, boys. Okay, but still working on that.
missed by much. Marty Holler, former All Black, part of the Hamilton Marist team who won the Waikato Championship last weekend, and wonderful to have experienced players like that back in our game at the National League level. Adam Byrne on the return, his carries have been strong tonight as well. Adam Byrne, McKenzie, Ambrose, Curtis, and Goodwood operating out on the right side. For Wellington, they're trying to hold him up in defence. Anton Leonard-Brown is holding Woodward up. He'll get the call. Great defence from Anton Leonard-Brown. Another player on debut tonight for Waikato.
Yeah, good defence, Waikato. They've been ever present.
30 seconds, come
on. All night tonight, you hear Woodward trying to take on the defence. Jordan Payne in there as well. And Zach Honick, three good defenders. It's a good turnover. Pressure back on Wellington now. Scrum time.
Yeah, it really has been a feature, hasn't it, Ben, tonight in this first quarter of an hour for Waikato on that occasion. They seem to be hunting in packs too. Three on one. Well, Jason Woodward was always going to lose that battle. A great attacking platform here.
Set, hold, hold.
Kinsey to the line. A little double pump. Was expecting the runner to come earlier. And then Wellington on the counter-attack through Tolmaa-Mea now. Via Fita from behind the advantage line. Jared Kahu. Faha Mokior again makes a small dent in the defence line. Brad Shields.
Use it!
For Fita. Now Kahu. Philly. Pelisuuma with a right foot step.
No.
Kahu, first receiver. Cut out ball for Via Fafita. The big right arm available, leading the upper side with a draw and pass. Adam Hill. Two defenders. Wellington now 5 metres out.
Tackle only.
Eric Sione on the advantage line.
Advantage slowing down.
Wellington, it's a penalty advantage. James Wall. 3 metres out. Philly, Treby, Ambrose Curtis. Ambrose Curtis got the right hand available. Ball back on the inside. Sean Treby, the try scorer.
Well, down the left hand side to start. Adam Hill made all the inroads and then they went wide. And just a good mismatch, some good speed. Ambrose Curtis putting on the afterburners and then a lovely little ball to this man on your screen now. So we'll go over Sean Treby. A good nail back against Waikato. See this side here. Fafita making a break and then a nice little offload. And that's good work from Lenny Apasai, Adam Hill, and Carl Tanana. Some good back play.
Some great back play. As you said, here's the injection from Ambrose Curtis. Just a little bit of speed there. And then again, the backing up and power shown there by Sean Treby, by like the number six, via Fafita. We saw him in the National Sevens for Wellington when they won their national title. Carrying on the legacy of great number sixes in Wellington with the likes of Jerry Collins, Levave, and now via Fafita. He's the one that made the inroads initially down this left-hand side. The backs were good enough to finish it off.
Jason Woodward, welcome back not only to Wellington but also to the Hurricanes for 2015. Out of St. Pat's Silver Street, the Upper Hutt Club, 2 seasons at the Rebels. From just outside the 22, Jason Woodward. He can't make good with the conversion. Victor Vito, Frey Wilson, Reg Goods, Mark Reddish. Well, there's some
last one, same please.
There's some talented same. Cattle right there that are all
you were good. Yeah.
On the injury list, and Sean Treby.
Come on!
Tony Feely with a midfield bomb. McKenzie. He looked like a kid out of school in 2013, and now a little blindside attack from Waikato, Brad Webber, Damien McKenzie into midfield, Morgan, Webber.
You pass the ball and you're holding him back.
Technical, you know, they're cleaning out beyond the ball.
Obstruction, three red.
Ruled obstruction. Waikato getting a roll in again. Brad Webber, I've been impressed with him. He's marshalling his troops around well at the base. That ruck at the scrum time around the mall as any good skipper in the number 9 jersey should be.
Ben Tamaifuna, you heard from the new PA system we've implemented with the referee being live here at the ground, and hopefully you can pick it up on your screens as well to help with the decisions. Especially for those that are inside the ground, Lenny Apisai again at the front of the line out for Via Fafita. And now Ambrose Curtis at first receiver breaks the first line of defence. They can run the football. They think about going the left side, and Brad Shields loses the ball in the tackle. And now Waikato think about countering attack from inside their own quarter. Morgan.
Holding on, 5 red.
I suppose this PA thing, Ben Castle, we're very much just a bit worried about the sledging of the referee from the players. I suppose that will improve if they hear themselves on the... But I guess if it helps promote the game and helps people get a better understanding.
Clearly, tackler got up and the first guy also got him too, so...
You hear the shouts from the crowd, don't you? What was that for? I can't do that anymore.
We'll just say, lucky it wasn't around when one Ken Laban was donning these fields, I tell you that. Loves a sledge.
I would have modified it. Woodward. Really nicely. Not that I want to preempt the Super 15 coaches in 2015, but Woodward at fullback, Corey Jane on the right wing, and Julian Savia on the left wing. There's a fair back three. Nonu and Conrad Smith in the centres. Bowden Barrett, TJ Petanana. It's not a bad looking back line for the Hurricanes in 2015. Captain as well and truly led from the front tonight. Brad Shields on the fringe of All Black selection. In the last year or so, Woodward's come through the New Zealand 20s program as well. Braden Mitchell for Nicholas Ross. Into midfield, and time Leonard Brown. It's a good carry from the young second 5'8". And muscle up and go forward. Waikato, the ball's loose. Jared Kahu, Sean Treby from a long way behind the advantage line goes wide. Far more Kior running like a centre and offloaded the ball in the tackle. Webber. Tamaifuna with the offload. McKenzie with the right footstep. Good play, both sides.
Hands three black.
Oh, a touch messy for both teams. A few mistakes, few errors. Throwing the ball around. Treby did sum up the situation pretty well for a counter-attack, but Waikato again up to the challenge. McKenzie, he's going to have another crack. Big Eric Sione.
Well, we see a lot of exciting number 10s come through in our game. Most recently, Aaron Cruden and Bowden Barrett. And just behind that group is a new group of kids. And this boy is one of them, Damien McKenzie. Ohio West is another one. Simon Hickey. All young boys, very, very talented. All got enormous futures in the game. And the ITM Cup, what a place to blood them.
Played a lot of 15 as well for the under-20s, New Zealand under 20 side. A very talented player.
Oh, that's good work from Adam Hill. He was the tackler, pinched the ball. Jared Kahu, Sione, Fahamokio. Again, thought about an offload, told Marmia. Wellington now in prime position. A little bit wider now for Lenny Apisai. Wellington in great field position. Waikato need to do some big defence. Jared Coe going short. Backs are available on the right. They've got a couple of forwards parked up on the left. Good run from Wall. Cleaning up from Brad Shields. Jared Coe. A little bit wider via Fafita. Back on the inside for Fahamokio. Kahu pinches a couple of metres. Jared Kahu. And the try line and touching distance for Wellington.
Time off.
Committee meeting.
Phil, TMO. Can we look here for a try, no try, double movement from three? From three black. We'll go back for the penalty.
We'll
otherwise.
Have a look here. Looks like Wellington, though. Wellington voting with their feet. They've hung around.
Well, that's... Is there a double movement?
And he's hit the ground. He's had another go.
It's a penalty.
Wellington are walking back to halfway.
So we're looking at Sione. He is tackled
there.
Promotes the ball. It's a double movement. It's a penalty. Waikato.
Yes, Phil. Sorry, so double movement. Yes.
Well, Wellington have gone back to halfway.
Going back to a penalty here for seven.
A long
side
jog
entry.
Back.
He was under advantage, so Wellington are going to get another crack. I don't like the rule, I have to say. Double movement rule, I've always been an opponent of it because I think Ben Castle's a reward for a bad tackle. But the rule's the rule.
So we've got a double movement there, but we've got a penalty here for seven for entry.
It came from a great turnover, didn't it, though, from Adam Hill. He was the tackler initially, got up, played
seven
the ball.
Entry.
The Waikato team all stood around and put their hands in the air, and he played on, and that's what got them to this position, Wellington.
They're going to go for the line out. And this Wellington being very ambitious. Good to see.
Look up to the front. Let's get around, eh? Yeah, just hands first. You need to get your hip first, then hands.
So Lenny Apisai. He's hit via Fafita a couple of times at the front of the line out.
Same.
This time it's the same area with a different jumper, Adam Hill. He played a big part in that last attack. That's a good drive from Waikato. Push Wellington back 5 metres beyond the point of the line out.
Doesn't have to, it's a maul.
Jared Kahu. via Fifita. Kahu. Philly with a drop goal in very good position off the post. Out off.
And the more he doesn't have to let it go on the ground.
Yeah. Well, potentially an easier opportunity to get 3 points a minute ago. Wellington off to the lineup. Half chance at a drop goal. Well, it's given possession now back to Waikato. They can relieve some pressure after again being camped down on their line. Wellington throwing everything at them.
Touched.
Damian McKenzie. And post Curtis. Jason Woodward, Fatonu Fili. Tolmar Mir with a nice left foot step and the ball. He's looking for Adam Hill. Lost forward. Good work from Honek. McKenzie. Tamiyafuna. Powerful run from the big front rower. McKenzie. They hit that left side. Again, a good run from Joe Weber. McKenzie. A little second man play. They promote the ball again on the right hand side. Honek. Ball goes over the top of McKenzie for Fetu Douglas.
Stephen Black on his feet, holding on.
Adam Hill. You could see that happening a mile away. A good leg chop tackle allowed him to get in over the top. Good attack from Waikato, but just... And Adam Hill is very good over the ball. You could see that.
Just about to say the same thing with regards to Waikato's attack. Being look very crisp, very structured, both backs and forwards. And the one opportunity Wellington needed, and Adam Hill took it. You can see there, great contact with the shoulder there by Sione and Adam Hill right there. Contesting the ball and they couldn't move him. Great technique there for open side. Watch that, kids at home.
Five out, five space.
And good carry from Morgan. So up his side again for Via Fifita. Jared Kahu is squeezed for room. Kahu, no option but to take it into contact. The ball's been stolen by Waikato. Good work from Uhila, the front rower. Now they can get a little bit wider. Waikato, there a chance down this left side. Joe Weber, he's got good footwork. Weber, too easy for the New Zealand 7-star out of Hamilton Boys High. He only needed half a chance and a brilliant finish from Joe Weber.
Oh, well, fantastic turnover, Lonnie Uhila. That's where it all started, and what an attack. That's the way to attack off a turnover, Waikato. You see it here, it's good defence. Kahu was squeezed, and there's the turnover. Well done, and look at the hands. Just good hands, putting them through. And this is impressive, Kautanani, like this, the afterburners, and then just to go on the outside.
Well, I like the basic skills under pressure, just catch and pass. Wellington will apply on it, but just watch that there, the Christmas, the pick up off the shoelaces, and the identification of where the space is, and backing your speed there, little skip. Always knew he was going to get on the outside there. Joe Weber, too good, he gets his double.
Fullback, Hamilton Boys High, first 15, not that long ago. New Zealand secondary schools, New Zealand sevens, New Zealand 20s. Another exciting kid in the game coming through. Joe Weber, two tries tonight. And Damian McKenzie. Uhila, front rower. Another prominent player in the Hamilton Marist team last week. Winning the club championship in the Waikato. And turning it on down here in Wellington. Woodward goes long. Declan O'Donnell. Adam Byrne, he's a good runner, Byrne.
This man here, entry. Two black entry.
In the upper side.
Two, did you?
It's just a bit too easy for Waikato at the moment. I mean, Wellington, they've thrown everything at it. Waikato's defence has been up to it, and it's just come down to a couple of critical moments. Here's Adam Byrne. He's carried off every kickoff tonight and carried well and strong. There's Lenny in through the side and entry. It's an easy out for Waikato. Now they have position inside Wellington's half.
Mitchell to the front of the line out. Weber, McKenzie. A cutout ball for Adam Byrne. Again, he goes to the line and recycles the ball. McKenzie. Weber's coming quickly on Fatuna Philly.
Red ball. Touched in flight. Touched in flight, red ball.
Oh, Waikato ball. What it is, all Waikato at the moment. We are
red ball.
A little over 6 minutes before the end of this first half. The pressure all on Wellington now. A great little touch from Damien McKenzie. Waikato will fancy themselves in this area of the park. Could well be a drive.
Brayden Mitchell for Nicholas Ross. Wheel around down the short side. Good momentum going forward. They're inside the five. Waikato, good numbers. Good control from Waikato. Tremendous kick. A very slick line out and a tremendous drive.
Oh, beautiful drive. Great to watch. It's Brayden Mitchell, the man they're back slapping there. He's pretty happy with that. That's their fourth try tonight. That is a bonus point, Waikato. Well, a little chip through from Damien McKenzie. Touched by a Wellington hand, which gave them this opportunity here where they set up the drive well. Their body positions are good. They're patient. They have another go. They get organised, and then they get the roll on. And then Ben Tamiafuna, he adds all his 140 kilos in there. Look at that. There's no stopping that. That's a great try, Waikato. A good forwards try.
Not the long, wide-ranging tries we like to see Carlton under, but nevertheless, still worth 5 points and a show of power and strength from the Waikato forwards.
Well, that's it. Structure at its premium, wasn't it? The forwards there, there's no way Wellington could break it up, and now this guy looks to convert.
Brayden Mitchell, he's been busy tonight. 108 kilos out of King's High School and Southland Boys High, playing for Morrinsville. Sean Treby, the try scorer for Wellington. Damien McKenzie. And quickly they shift the ball to the left side where they're so dangerous. Leonard Brown in a little bit of space coming on the inside as Weber gets away from the tackle of Jared Coe. Anton Leonard Brown, what a try! One of the best individual efforts you'll see in the ITM Cup in 2014. Anton Leonard Brown.
Oh, that's one of the greats. Anton Leonard Brown, how did no one stop him? Some beautiful running for this young talent. Out of New Zealand, under 20s. Here's McKenzie. Still with the ball alive, and here Anton Leonard Brown inside his 22, and look at him go, some good speed. Oh, just swerve and power. And how did he? Oh, just a lovely step on the outside. Kaltanana, you'll be pretty impressed with that.
One thing that's really stood out for me in this Waikato back line is they have gas, all of them. Damien McKenzie, Leonard Brown, Jordan Payne, Weber. They've all got that natural ability and speed, and there's no substitute for it. On the rugby field, and five tries in 40 minutes. These young kids, look at the confidence of them.
Captain of the New Zealand 20s in 2014, Anton Leonard Brown out of Christchurch Boys High School. And Damien McKenzie, finally.
Well, they're just playing with so much confidence, these young guys. Here's Johnny Walters, he'll be pretty happy. Coach of the Waikato side. Big Carl Hoft in front of him. Pleased with some of the work of his forwards.
Uhila, this big front row. Look at him carrying the ball like it's a tennis ball. Very good carry. Damien McKenzie again at first receiver. And now Ben Tamiafuna running in a bit of traffic. The big front rower does tremendous. Now the pick and go, Lenny Upside with an important tackle. Damien McKenzie is putting a kick behind Mamir, but it just on the full.
Time off. Got all our time for a boot. Gentlemen, I've got to let him get his boot off.
Adam Hill.
Give
him a costume malfunction, form of a boot. And plenty of footy to come on Sky Sport and the Rugby Channel. Of course, our attention later tonight will switch to Sydney, where Bledisloe Cup 1 of 2014 will be played, and there's still plenty of ITM Cup rugby to come in the next couple of days as well. Tasman will host Hawke's Bay tomorrow from Lansdowne Park in Blenheim, kick-off at 2:30, and then Toll Stadium in Whangarei, Northland, Taniwha and the Manawatu Turbos, 4:35 tomorrow afternoon, and 9 o'clock tonight on Sky Sport 1. The All Blacks shooting for that record 18 straight wins against the in-form Wallaby team, of course, celebrating their Super 15 success, with the Waratahs beating the Crusaders in this year's Super 15 final. And of course, early in the morning, Argentina and South Africa from Pretoria. Lenny Upisai with a full line out. The movement in the line, the referee.
So, red, the more you yell, the less we're going to do. Black, line out. That's not excited, that's annoying.
So what's he saying? I'm not allowed to talk now. Up his side.
Stay.
In the front of the line out. Good work in defence. Great work in defence from Fetu Douglas.
Over. Scrum's over here.
Yeah, high just, fives all round.
Sorry, Ken, you can just see the body language, can't you? Waikato, they're pumped. Wellington, a little dejected at the moment. They're their coaches, Chris Boyd and Richard Watt. They have a fairly stern message, I would say, at halftime for their troops. They'll squeeze this scrum out here. There's been Tamiafuna, been very present in the scrum and in the tight.
Hold.
Brad Webber, not that long out of school either, the Waikato halfback and captain. Look at these kids. O'Donnell, Leonard Brown, McKenzie. And Brad Webber, and he's the captain. Again, most certainly getting younger.
Out. Bind. Sit. Hold.
Brad Webber. Adam Byrne holds at the back. And Webber says that'll do us for half time. 30 points to 11. And given their moderate 2013 form, they will be very, very impressed with the opening 40 minutes of the ITM Cup here in 2014. And Carl Tanana, we're just hoping to grab a quick word with returning Highlander Sean Treby, who's with Carl.
Sean, they just seem to be attacking at great speed, eh?
Yes, pretty disappointing from our point of view. Two easy tries. D's really been soft out wide, so we're going to have to make sure we do a lot better in the second half.
Good luck, eh?
Cheers, mate.
So a tremendous half from the visitors, Waikato, who lead Wellington at half-time here at Westpac Stadium, 30 points to 11. Well, the home team, Wellington, they have got some challenges. Their coach, Chris Boyd, with Carlton Anna.
Well, coach, after their first initial try, you were able to hold the ball for a number of phases and get your own points back?
Yeah, unfortunately, we did that to start with, but unfortunately at the end, that last 13 or 14 minutes, we conceded a couple of soft tries and it was a bit of a blow for us before half-time.
Suppose the biggest issue for you was the missed tackles?
Yeah, certainly the one-on-one stuff is not good. We had a couple of defensive systems errors too, but we're not unhappy about the 11. Should have been a few more, but the 30's a breaker for us at the moment.
So what's the main thing the boys need to concentrate on to get back in and win this one?
Oh, look, I think that the tendency is to chase it. When you've got a young group, they're looking to chase everything, so we just got to stick to our systems and process, and hopefully that can get us through.
All right, good luck for the second half, coach.
Thanks very much.
Oh, very, very impressive. Waikato team in this first half. They will just want to state the obvious, Ben, more of the same. Good.
Wait for the whistle, please.
There's no doubt we've heard from both Chris Boyd and Sean Treby that defence will be big for them.
Headband in front.
What's that start like? The coach won't even be in his box.
Yeah, frustrating.
This man here in front.
Didn't get any more obvious than that, so more frustration for the home team Wellington and potentially more joy for Waikato.
Crouch!
As the Waikato backs, there's their shape. Two on the left, two on the right, and two immediately behind the scrum, so a multiple of options for these kids the way that they're playing. It's McKenzie coming from the back of the scrum to the left side and dribbles the ball along the ground. A very, very mature play from a young kid.
Just hold on for this one.
Well, we've just started a mistake. Wellington, we heard from Chris Boyd that there's this young group. They tend to chase the game a bit. They move away from structure, and it's case in point, just trying to get a bit eager off the kickoff. Now pressure on Wellington.
Fatunu Fili. Brad Shields in midfield, Jared Kahu.
Hold black.
Philly.
Is it in touch?
Ball's out.
Well, it's quite lucky that ball is out. Joe Weber on the far right-hand side. He had some numbers outside him as well, and the way he's been going could well have been interesting. But a good clearance nonetheless, Wellington.
Mitchell, quick throw, McKenzie. In time, Leonard Brown. Hit by Treby.
Leave two!
Followed by a pick and go. And short ball for forwards operating close to the ruck and maul. So Waikato just trying to draw in Wellington defenders. And McKenzie just inside the half. Puts the ball behind Ambrose Curtis. Stays in the field of play. Curtis forced the kick, so Waikato will throw to an attacking line out. They've started the second half the way they finished the first.
Good play there, getting it in behind the head. Good lucky bounce of the ball though, Damian McKenzie, as we're down. I think there's a bit of trouble in the midfield for Waikato. There is Anton Leonard Brown.
Yeah, you have to make a decision.
He's had a great first half.
Kids had a great 2014. Interesting, I was looking over the team sheet of the same game that I did 2 years ago, Wellington Waikato 2012. Joe Weber is the only survivor of the Waikato team from that game just 2 years ago. Woodward, Treby, Eric Sione, interestingly, the only three for Wellington, so the players turn over quickly in our game at the elite level now.
Six, R, T, P, nope.
Waikato. They've got field position. And Jason Woodward. Anderson and jersey 22 is on now, and Waikato.
Six obstruction. Six red obstruction.
An obstruction or just lazy running. Fetu Douglas. Just on that kick receipt. There's Anton Leonard Brown there. Some treatment to an ankle, it seems.
Well, this is the opportunity that Wellington needed, isn't it, Ben, just to settle things down. They need to get their hands on the ball, just a slow drive here, and try and just come away with some points and get the second half started on a positive.
It's a key 13 minutes, wasn't it, that Chris Boyd spoke to you about at halftime, just where they went away from game plan, went off their tackles. Now they're able to access the game now.
Lenny Apisai, he was looking for Christian Lloyd.
That's Ford Red. That's Ford Red. In the line-out. Back scrum.
Well, he's been good tonight, hasn't he? The loose head for Wellington. Whakamokio, first mistake he's made. You see just the body language of the Wellington team. Comes down here, it's scrappy. He passes back to his halfback and gets a Falcon. Oh, accuracy or lack of here from the Lions is costing them.
So the tackling opportunity for Wellington. They've got all six players lined up on the open side. There's the shape of the Wellington attack that Waikato defensively is looking at. Shields, Kahu, Philly, cut out ball in midfield, and then another long ball for Ambrose Curtis with a right foot step on Nikoro. Wellington with the drive and excellent field position. Kahu and Christian Lloyd back to blind side. Woodward, Curtis at halfback, Jared Kahu at first receiver. Now James Wall, Kahu, Philly, a little second man play for Tolmamea. Kahu, Lloyd.
That's three.
Yeah, Wellington, it's another guys, error.
Lost forward.
Oh, it's tough. There's Jared Kahu there, just a slight knock on.
Time off.
A bit messy at the breakdown.
We've got a change here for Wellington in jersey 18.
Time's off.
Henry Stowers is coming on, replacing number four, James Wall. See him there.
Time's off.
It's just hard to get continuity with all these mistakes from the Wellington team, just getting too egos. Chris Boyd said maybe trying to chase the game a bit too much, getting too eager. A lot of time to go in this game. Just need to be settled and composed.
And Waikato, they don't mind to defend either. They're good on defence. They pride themselves on defence. The likes of Marty Holler, who is on the bench tonight. He was their defence coach last year. Always a very, very good defender.
And don't forget, coming up tonight, after this game, we're going to Sydney, where our coverage, former All Black Murray Pearce, 1987 Rugby World Cup winner, Pearcey, and is still a very keen follower of the game, and good to see him here looking in good health too. 9 o'clock our coverage starts from Sydney for the All Blacks and the Wallabies. Bledisloe Cup 1 in 2014. What a game it's going to be.
Good centre, boys. Keep it up. Go, Red.
Hold nine. I've got nine.
Crouch.
Kenzie, how about
bind
this kick?
Set. Stable. Up, up, up.
Webber. Seems like yesterday he was playing for Napier Boys High. Webber
was outside.
Anderson, a little stop and goes close to the touchline. Toll Marmia with the tackle. Webber
carried back.
A little bit of depth now is Waikato go looking for field position. Ambrose Curtis has got some wheels. Woodward showed the ball on the inside, promoted it back for Sean Treby. Good aggressive defence from Waikato. Jared Kahu again at first receiver. Lloyd. Philly. Oh, drop ball. Penalty advantage.
Yeah, just a bit lazy at the breakdown. Lonnie Wheeler. Not one fast red, enough, roll not quicker. Rolling away fast enough. But Waikato on defence, aside from that indiscretion there, they're very quick to be organised on defence.
We hear coaches talk about defensive or systems, as they put it. Don't you be seeing them for Waikato? Their defensive systems are very organised. They're always getting more than one in the tackle. They're getting two, a lot of times three. Against one attacker, well, if they don't turn it over, they're able to slow the ball down. That's been Wellington's problem.
Money! 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 Money!
Vinny up his sign. It's time to the middle of the line out. His throw for Wellington, and it's a good drive. Adam Hill's got possession of the football at the back of the mall. A good meters going forward. And now the advantage with Wellington. That's a good line out and a good drive. The pick and go towards the open side via Fafita's missed out. Christian Lloyd is the player selected to receive the ball. Now Philly, a little bit of footwork and then a decoy play. Ambrose Curtis from a standing start tries to offload the football in the tackle. Woodward, Tolmamia. Ball's gone back, it's untidy. Faha Mokior. Wellington looking dangerous.
Oh, a little bit of possession, a little bit of go forward, but they're coming back. Yeah, number three, Ben Tamiafuna. Indiscretion there.
Three red.
Just coming in off the maul. It was a good maul they had set. They're going to have another look.
Goal line.
There he is, Big Ben.
I think he was just about to lean over at his knees and he saw himself on the big screen and stood back up.
He's
been good tonight though, hasn't he? The two props for Waikato. Wheel has made a number of strong tackles, but Ben Tamiafuna have been active as well.
Positive.
Around the park. Here they go, Wellington.
Hold.
Up beside this time to the middle of the line out. Wellington joins at the back. Adam Hill is there as well. They try to get some momentum going forward. Wellington through the middle. Wellington, the referee's in good position.
Held up, scrum five.
And says good defence. I think it's Fetu Douglas, the blindside flanker, or Weber. They come up with a big play in defence.
Let's go.
I think it's Weber, the skipper, just underneath. Wow.
Let's go. Marks made. Let's go.
Look at that. Well done.
And Mitchell and Weber showing plenty of ticker in defence. Hold out Adam Hill.
Find. Sit. Hold.
Jared Kahu.
Our first.
Some pressure coming through Waikato. Ben Tamiafuna, especially on that right-hand side, there's Lonnie Uhila and Braden Mitchell up against Eric Sione, Lenny Upperside, and Tolu Whakamoe. McCoy. See Ambrose Curtis floating outside behind the scrum. They need a solid platform here, Wellington.
It's a good scrum, Brad Shields. Holds, it's untidy. Philly, back on the inside, Treby. The captain, Brad Shields.
Leave red! Hold red! Use
the back of the ruck. Kahu with a little bit of width for Vaia Fafita. Kahu. far more Kiora bounces off the first defender. Kahu with a left side play, Adam Hill. Couple of metres short. Yeah, a little bit wider, coming back for a penalty. Nice ball from Kahu to Adam Hill.
Offside. 22 red, offside.
Henderson.
Too many penalties.
They're asking the question, aren't they, this Wellington team? Phase after phase, attack after attack, and Waikato at the moment are being staunch in their defence. I think 22. Their line speed, though, is questionable, this Waikato team. Really testing the referee, but Brad Shields knows he needs to get some points and pretty quick.
Up his side for Christian Lloyd and Adam Hill again at the back.
Same ball.
Brad Shields joins.
Leave red one.
Christian Lloyd cleans up. Waikato, Uhila with a beautiful offload and the tackle as well. Not a lot of room for O'Donnell, but he does well. Damien McKenzie says, let's get out of here. And that is a great save from Waikato on defence.
Well, we've talked about it all night. It's a great turnover. Look at the defence, they're up, they're eager. And they're over the ball, they're fighting, and the ball just popped out, there it was. Lonnie Uhila, good offload. Well, it relieves pressure. Waikato, they deserve to get out. Wellington with another opportunity.
Again, up his side for Fifita, Philly. Decoy play. Woodward is a bit wider now. Ambrose Curtis with a little bit of room. Nikoro, good with the tackle.
Use it!
Kahu. Lloyd. Into contact.
Leave red! No, Mike.
Kahu, Philly, quickly for Treby. A little attack kick along the ground.
Two for me. Black three, sub.
Couple of changes here in the front row for Wellington. Lads on in jersey 16, James O'Reilly replacing up his side, and also in jersey 17, Taniela Koroi is coming on for Eric Sione.
Looking for some energy. It's been a quality debut for Lenny up his side, 54 good minutes. James O'Reilly, who's come on in jersey 16, he was the New Zealand 20s hooker. He's only a year older than Apisai, still young, out of the Hutt Old Boys Marist Club. Into his work straight away, McKenzie.
It's carried back.
Woodward. Ambrose Curtis. Good defence, Waikato, Jared Kahu, Sean Treby. Treby. Looked on the inside and then.
Leave nine!
Mamia. Fairly quickly for Koroi.
Forward pass.
Tamiyafuna, I think, reminding the referee the ball was four.
Oh, it's good line speed, Waikato. They're forcing the mistake. Just seems Waikato, they wouldn't mind Wellington holding onto the ball for the rest of the game, the way they defend, they talk, they're organised. Just forced a forward pass out of there. Now there's opportunity now for Waikato.
Red.
Just in Wellington side of halfway. Damien McKenzie just in behind the scrum there.
Bind. Set. Hold.
Yeah, well, it looks like Soiolo's going to come in a minute here for Wellington. But I'm with you, Ben. Just get the feeling that Waikato are back in their defence. I wouldn't mind Wellington just getting in position and getting down their other end of the field with the kick. They're just chasing the game, as Chris Boyd said they tended to do. when they're behind. This Waikato team being lethal. You can see the two, McKenzie and Nikoro, directly behind the scrum. They pick which way they're going to load up and try and create the numbers mismatch. They've gone left once.
We're about there on the right side and just puts the ball in behind the Wellington defence. Very sensible rugby, very clinical.
11 black, 11.
So James Soialo coming onto the field, younger brother of All Black Rodney Soialo, to replace Tau Mamea. Manu Samoa player in the last couple of years as well. Soialo's been playing 5'8 for the Tawa Club in the local club competition here in recent times. James Soialo, quality footballer.
Wait, stop him. 10 black.
Sub. Sorry, James boys. O'Reilly, top of your screen.
Send him out.
Another young kid coming on too here, Ken. Wes Husson in jersey 21 for Wellington, also replacing Fatun Fili.
Just out of Wellington College, 2013. Wes Goosen was in the same first 15 last year with Lenny Upisai. And James O'Reilly out of Hutt International Boys and Hutt Old Boys Marist. And the ball going behind Kuroi. Waikato. Thought they had the ball. Some nice counter rucking. And Soialo sends the ball down deep. Nikoro. Weba. Got some zip the outside backs for Waikato. McKenzie with a probing kick.
Someone got a mark.
Oh, it's going to be too big.
Where is he?
Oh, he's Brent. Been impressive. Come. McKenzie.
About here?
Yeah, look at that stat there. Time in opposition 22.
Boys.
12 minutes.
Over here.
And no change to the score.
All right. Mark Wade.
Territory still sitting around 70% Wellington. That scoreboard has not changed. Waikato defending. There is Wes Goosen.
Exciting talent as well. Goosen, a tremendous player, a wonderful age grade.
Set. Hold.
Career as well on debut tonight. Shields goes down the left side. Soialo to the line. Jared Kahu via Fafita from a standing start. An easy target for Adam Byrne over the top. Kahu. Treby. A little bit of width on the pass and then a nice ball. Wellington. Kahu. Lloyd. Soialo, Woodward. O'Reilly's running out in the tram lines.
Bradley!
Fafita. Soialo. Kuroi.
Four out!
Good tackle, Ross. Tree beat. Goosen. Players out. Touch judge with his flag up.
Can you see the difference in attack there from Wellington? Very deep, and it's easy for the Waikato defence to just drift off and pick up the numbers and just read it. But this is good interchange here. They were closer to the line, they were flatter, and they really stressed the defence of Waikato, and as a consequence were able to make a lot of yards.
So Fafita, Soialo, Woodward, Curtis. This time a grubber kick along the ground behind the defence. Nikoro couldn't tidy the ball up. Woodward missed it.
Ball's available.
Referee's happy and then very close. I'm not sure about that play. O'Donnell.
Fairly low percentage option, Declan O'Donnell. The way they're playing though, this outside, full of confidence, these young boys. has put his team under a bit of pressure, but Wellington showing a bit more intent, and they use the ball.
What's your call?
James O'Reilly to throw to full line out.
Lloyd. Adam Hill.
He's fine, he's all part of it.
Good work, Wheeler.
Leg down one!
Yeah, that second grab. And the quick tap. Jared Kahu, yes, a brilliant individual try from Jared Kahu. He's trying hard tonight. And he's rewarded. He's been a threat tonight, either at the base or a first receiver. He's parked up a few times tonight. And this time, seizing the opportunity. That's a smart try from Jared Kahu.
Well, he's been a good performer in Wellington Club Rugby out of the Petone Club. There he is, takes the opportunity. Waikato napping. That's a good try, and it's just what Wellington need now.
One thing you can't do, and that's basics again from Waikato. The first time they switched off, they turned their back to Kahu, saw it, seized the opportunity, and he's been good tonight. His distribution's been very snappy from the base. That's some great reward, and exactly what Wellington need. They get another try. Still a long time to go. Getting into the last quarter.
Just inside the left hand. Point, so 30 points to 18. And a better second half from Wellington so far, to state the obvious. McKenzie. Henry Stowers, the ball's gone forward. Captain of the Samoan under 20s, Henry Stowers, out of Scots College in Wellington. And with the Wainuiomata Rugby Club. On debut tonight, and the Waikato backs will be very excited about this opportunity that's been handed to them. A scrum with tremendous field position on the left-hand side of the park. All six backs have parked up to the open side. He's a threat. Weber and O'Donnell, McKenzie, Weber, so they've got plenty of options. Waikato. Weber. Tell them why we just don't play on in those situations.
Well, the ball's sitting there. I'm with you, Ken.
Albert Nikoro out of Mount Albert Grammar. New Zealand secondary schools player as well. Good kid, and made his debut for the Blues.
Crouch! Matilani! Bind! Set!
Adam Byrne holds the ball at the back.
14 hold.
McKenzie to the line, a double pump of the ball. Pirouettes out of the tackle. Very good running from Waikato. They got great field position, the pick and go. And the try scored after the initial bust. Tremendous football from Waikato.
Oh, brilliant football. All started a fantastic scrum. A great platform to work off, and a sleight of hand. Damien McKenzie working a fantastic move. Jordan Payne with the break. Well, off that mistake off the kickoff from Wellington, and they've been punished. We'll see the replay here off a fantastic base, and there it is. Oh, the dummy Jordan Payne, a missed tackle, and then Braden Mitchell. Bang, over.
What's the speed of the ball, isn't it, BC? You see the options there. Sean Treby won't be happy with that effort. Just a little pirouette and spin, and then just look at that. There's no way the Rots can get it in place, and that's easy pickings for Waikato. I've had a number of changes too. James McGugan's come on in jersey 17 and jersey 21 f- Wharenui Hawera and my man Marty Holler, the ex-All Black in jersey 19. What a luxury to bring a dude like that on. Brilliant.
And Marty Holler, 36 games for the All Blacks. Pretty handy replacement. He won't like me mentioning he is 37 years old. Comparatively to some of these boys out there, he is the grandfather of the side.
A young man there, Sheridan Rangihuna, in jersey 20 on for Wellington, replacing Jared Kahu.
Woodward, bit of get from the kick in. Really good take. Waikato with a little half break down the right side, and then a sudden stop. Stowers with a quick throw. Woodward, decent.
Off the feet, play on, off the foot. Leverage!
Anguhuna, Soialo, Koroi, inside ball for Fifita.
No.
Anguhuna, Henry Stowers to the line. Soialo, long ball for Treby. Another long ball for Ambrose Curtis. And Woodward, another little chip and chase, and it's out on the full.
Oh, a bit more spark out there, KT. It sounds like Wellington are starting to talk a bit more. They've got their tails up a bit.
Yeah, and there's some big contact going in as well, I'll tell you, Ben.
Mitchell.
He's all right.
Clayton Mitchell at the back. Weber with a little probing kick for Ambrose Curtis, who's safe under the high ball. Slips two defenders on the return. Nice play from Ambrose Curtis. Now Henry Stowers. Rangihuna. Soialo. A couple of decoy plays as James O'Reilly.
Leverage.
Running out in midfield. Rangihuna. Good work from Soialo, and now Brad Shields.
Leverage.
Good defense again. Waikat. Rangihuna with a left side play. Ope Peleseuma. Rangihuna. Soialo. Via Fifita, the big right hand available. Couldn't offload the ball, goes to ground. Back to left, Soialo misses out two players for Goosen. Brad Shields with a short ball. Peleseuma.
Oh, good defence, Waikato again. It's a lot of rugby from Wellington. They're throwing a lot at it. They're certainly not going to die wondering.
He's not the line out, playing on.
You hear the message there from Shane McDermott. They're going to play on, Waikato.
So Mitchell for Nicholas Ross. And now into midfield.
Leave seven.
Another short side play. Wharenui Hawera. Lloyd.
Six. Leave it three.
Rangihuna. Soialo. Trying to put the ball behind now, but Nikoro doesn't take it on the full. Good tackle, Treby. Soialo. Woodward straightens up in the middle of the park. Treby. into the backfield. Treby with some nice footwork. One on one. Good run from the second 5'8". Ball's loose. It's a good steal from Waikato. Harwater.
Carried back.
And now Waikato. From inside their own quarter. Couldn't make the pass.
Carried back.
Weber. And Whanganui. Harwater.
Time. He's subbed, he's injured.
Sean Treby.
Well, he's been near their best tonight, hasn't he, Ken? Sean Treby's been powerful as always, but leading from the front. Slipped off a couple of tackles and then just the knock on there, but he's been good. I think they needed to get the ball to him more here, Sean Treby, just to get the go forward.
2 hours from kickoff, but our coverage begins at 9 p.m. from Sydney, Rugby Championship, this Bledisloe Cup game. And then tomorrow afternoon, Tasman will host Hawke's Bay at 2:30, Sky Sport 1 in the Rugby Channel, followed by the Northland Taniwha and the Manawatu Turbos, 4:35 from Toll Stadium in Whangarei. In Argentina and South Africa at 3 o'clock in the morning, if you've got nothing to do with your life, you can watch a lot of footy, Ben Castle.
What are you saying, Ken?
Looking for a reason to get out of the dishes. So less than 10. Waikato disappointed with their 4-6 in 2013. What a statement they've made so far tonight. 5 tries in the first half to 1 apiece in the second half. Wellington have come back stronger in the second half. But this young Waikato side and the Wellington team with some kids in it as well have given us a game tonight.
No. They're relatively unknown and a pretty fresh-faced
so we're too
Waikato
close.
Side, but
so we're leaning.
It's fair to say so everyone will be talking about them. After this performance, they've been strong up front and they've been very dynamic out the back, very exciting. They've got some big game players. Some adjustments out there.
Yeah, I think that's Jordan Payne coming off. There's no respite because that's allowed McKenzie to come back on the fullback.
Set, hold.
So Rangahuna, the young kid himself. James Soyalo with an inside ball for Goosen, well read by Harwer on defence. Now a long ball for Lloyd and then a little decoy player. Wellington a chance out of his left side. James O'Reilly is hit in the head hard of the tackle, O'Reilly, by Ben Tamifuna.
Tom, who?
Oh, what an effort, Ben Tamifuna, to get over. Oh, this big contact here. Here he comes, Ben Tamifuna, on the left of your screen now. James O'Reilly, bang.
He was the second man in, too, from the sideline. Looking after the inside of Weber there, Ben Tamifuna. Been strong tonight, the big number 3. Loves a bit of contact.
Yeah, making a cover tackle in the 72nd minute for the heaviest man on the park as well. It just shows you that there's some effort and some character in this boy. Harrison Levine coming in, grandson Howard, 8 tests for the All Blacks out of Otago. Harrison himself, he's just a kid not long out of school. Hamilton Boys High.
National champ last year.
Oh, just waiting for a sub. I'm waiting for that guy.
Looks like night over for Wes Goosen, unfortunately.
Hang on, time, so we'll see what one more come. Let's get him on, eh?
Yeah, Bart Donofili, come on, sorry, Ken.
No luck for
time on.
Goosen.
Time you drop.
Experience Bart Donofili comes back. And Nicholas Ross.
That's one tough!
Whanganui, Harwater and Levine in the halves now for Waikato, conjuring up a play to get them some pretty good field position.
Oh, great clearance kick, Waikato. We've mentioned it tonight, talking about these young kids. This is the beauty of ITM Cup. We get to see this young talent on show. Players that perform at club level, they get rewarded on the big stage. pushing for higher honours. There's been some real good talent on here tonight.
And Riley to the front of the line out for Fifita Soyalo, Treby. Good run from Treby. The ball's available. It's stolen by Marty Holler.
Leave now, Black 12.
Waikato. Bit of advice
actually, no,
from
it's a maul.
The referee. It's a maul. So use it or lose it. Good defence from Wellington. And Greg Foy, the captain of a Wellington Sevens team in 2014, who played so well and did so well leading his team to the national championship. Carl Tanana, he's a boy with some talent and some presence. And Adam Hill has had a good game tonight.
Yeah, he's a great, great guy to bring on. There's Foy, outstanding with his leadership, as you highlighted. Now he gets a chance here.
Coach!
Let's acknowledge our global audience taking
steady,
coverage of the ITM Cup in 2014. Massive coverage around the world as Rangahuna looks for a play down the right side, and Woodward! Well, the no-look pass ended up finding Adam Byrne.
Side entry. This guy here. Four, side entry.
Terrell. Waikato, Waikato player from the side. Joining ruck incorrectly. There's Jason Woodward hurrying things along. Experience. Good to see him back in a Lions jersey. Wellington here. 26 caps for Melbourne Rebels. Jason Woodward, 200 points. Pretty handy footballer.
James O'Reilly.
It's a sack, straight sack from four.
The line out goes to ground straight away. Rangahuna with the decision sends the big men forward. There's the play for Wellington, 2.5 metres out. James O'Reilly tried to go under two defenders. Lloyd at the back. Fahamoa Kior. Rangahuna. Fifita, Fifita, too easy. We talked about Greg Foy, all involved with the Wellington Sevens team, and via Fifita, this man on your screen, he was, as Carl Tanana alluded to earlier in our coverage, he was one of the stars of the National Sevens in 2014.
Well, it's good reward for a patient build-up. The forwards getting involved, doing the tight stuff, and then just, you know, a good little bit of footwork from Fifita.
Yeah, Fifita, he's been good tonight. And the thing here for Wellington, they want to get this conversion over quickly and try and get another try and get that bonus point for the four.
Woodward. That's what was required.
Well, only a couple of minutes left, Ken. If they get another try, they get within seven plus the four bonus, so still a lot on this line here. Here comes a kickoff.
Henry Stowers. Safe under the ball. Rangahuna. Fifita. No room on the right, so comes back towards the middle. Hard to pull down the big blindside flanker. Soyalo. Brad Shields, second receiver. Rangahuna. So Wellington looking for some quick recycles. Rangahuna. Soyalo. Marty Holler.
No release.
Rangahuna. Shields with a long ball for Ambrose Curtis. Close to the touchline, throws the ball back on the inside via Fifita. Two Waikato players over the ball, but Wellington secure. O'Reilly plays halfback. Now Lloyd, the second wave of attack, Fatonu Fili, a big dummy on the inside, looking for support, gives it short on the outside. Ooh, good work in defence from Waikato. Wellington aggressive going forward. Pele Su'uma, the player, penalised. But good work at the breakdown, Waikato.
No, oh, it's been Waikato all night at the breakdown and on the defensive line. It's Adam Byrne that time getting over the ball in great position. He's done well. He's carried hard, Adam Byrne, the number eight for Waikato tonight. And on that time there, on defence, good job.
What a Nui. Well, they'll be feel pretty pleased. It's 4-6 in 2013. Waikato, what a way for them to start their 2014 campaign. And they've done tremendous work in the off-season. This is basically a new side that's been put together. And the program and the plan that's been operating. And then you look at it coming up against a team that is no stranger to the big games in the ITM Cup. And Waikato's organisation, their professionalism and their execution, particularly for long periods of time in the first half, was absolutely outstanding, and they're going to be rewarded tonight with a very, very good win, Waikato. Adam Byrne, their leader, Ben Castle, just mentioned he's been outstanding. McKenzie, this kid with the ball, well, what a future he's got in the game. Damian McKenzie, just out of school, running and playing like a veteran. And Marty Holler. Hawera. Veen.
There's too many bodies on the ground.
Young kids. Scrum red.
Play the scrum, it's been awarded. Let's go.
They've been good tonight, Uhila, front rower. They can feel pretty pleased. Done a great job as club team. We've had a great season as well. He was tremendous in the club final. He's carried that on to the ITM Cup. This has been an impressive display from Waikato.
Binds.
Harrison Levine.
Set.
Is outside him. Whareanui Hawara, the first 5'8". He's not long out of St. Peter's College as well. Another kid we've seen in Land Rover first 15 rugby.
Let's go, boys. Crouch! Bind! Sit! Hold steady, steady!
Levine, Rangahuna, two young halfbacks with Howard out to the line, a little double pump, and then the ball held up for Anderson. Marty Holler. Veen, a little short ball on the right. And the big man coming forward, the ball's gone forward, that'll do us. 30 points to 11 at half time. 37 points to 25, the final score, an outstanding debut for Damian McKenzie. Disappointment for Jason Woodward, and the captain of Waikato, Brad Webber, with Carlton.
Well, Brad, you come here with a good win under your belt, mate. Must feel pretty good.
Oh, absolutely, mate. The media have been writing us off all week coming up to this, saying that we're a young team and whatnot, but I think we showed that age doesn't matter in this competition. These guys have been picked because they're good enough, and they showed that they're good enough tonight to beat a top Wellington side.
Yeah, I was about to say that. A lot of young, yes, new, fresh faces in the team. What was the build-up like, knowing you had such an experienced side?
Well, I've been saying it throughout all our build-up that if you're good enough, then you're old enough. So these boys showed that they were good enough tonight. And, you know, youth doesn't matter, man. These guys are class players. A lot of people probably didn't know who these guys were. They will after this competition, I'll tell you that much.
Definitely, and I suppose it was a performance that was really based on your defence. It was outstanding tonight. That's where it all started from.
Yeah, mate. We talked about the try line being our own house and protecting our house, and I thought we protected it really well tonight. Well,
great effort, pretty much the perfect one. Congratulations. Good luck for the rest of the tournament. Eh?
Cheers, Katie.
Brad, I know, disappointing effort from you guys first up. You had periods, though, that you were able to contest, but it was in bits and pieces, wasn't it?
Yeah, definitely. We can take some huge confidence out of that game, you know. We played most of the footy in that second half. We just couldn't capitalise, as you say, and that's crucial in this ITM Cup. We need to hold on to the ball.
Still a very young squad, though, mixed in with a couple of experienced guys like yourself. So it's only game one. Still a lot of water to go under the bridge.
It is a long competition, and as I said, we can take huge confidence from that. There's guys playing well, but we just need to sort out those little individual errors that's costly in the opening rounds.
Yeah, just can't. Well, you weren't able to seem to get a roll on with those little mistakes, and it was sort of stop and start, didn't it?
Yeah, that's the one. We'll go back on Monday and look at the tapes and we'll see what we did wrong and hopefully come out better off against Northland next week.
Well, I know you're a proud man. First time you're leading the Lions. Congratulations on that and good luck for the rest of the tournament. Eh?
Cheers, Carl. Thanks, mate. Appreciate it.
Yes, our thanks to Brad Shields and Brad Webber. 37 points to 25. Waikato over Wellington.
Yeah!